good friends Harsh Nivatia and Jyotsna ji, delegates in this convention. It is always a pleasure to be in the annual extraordinary meeting of the FICCI. This relationship began in the year 2000 when I came to Delhi for the first time as a member of parliament. Then I became a union minister in the Bajpayee government. When I was out of power, I'm happy FICCI did not forget me. When I have become a senior minister in the Narendra Modi government, FICCI remembers me. My only hope, when I cease to be a minister, which is not in a very distant future as we see, FICCI will not forget me. My greetings to all of you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, Arunji, having inaugurated the convention, he must have unfolded the agenda of our government, from reforms to policy decision, etc. Let me very briefly indicate to you what I see as the thrust of our government. The first and foremost is, it is not a routine government elected. Narendra Modi's government is a transformative government designed to make India an acknowledged world power. This first recognition of the objective is important. And if you will see from the policy paralysis being addressed to the so many decisions being taken to an immediate metamorphosis in the impression of India globally. All are indications of that. Let me begin very briefly on foreign policy. We had a problem with Pakistan for the last so many years. But did you notice the great tectonic shift in the understanding of the world towards the concern of India? I'm not talking of India's neighbors. I'm not talking of Europe. I'm not talking of America. But be it Saudi Arabia, be it Qatar, be it Dubai, be it Muscat, all the countries understood India as an important, stable world power. And therefore, we need to reorient our own understanding of the regional security and India's role in that. In the last couple of months, I had occasion to travel in different parts of the country on behalf of our government. And 3-4 ambassadors told me, and I need to recall, they said, "We are in the foreign service, we become ministers after nearly 30 years of service. But the kind of respect we are getting today as ambassadors of India, we have rarely seen in our previous stints." These are important changes which are happening. There is one ideological premise of our government which you need to understand. This whole debate between equity and growth is a very long perennial debate. Garibi mitegi, nahi mitegi, kitna vikas hona chahiye. In our view, and that is very important to be appreciated, growth without equity is possible. But genuine equity can never come unless there is proper growth. If you have 10 breads only to distribute, there will be longer line, more pressure. If you have 1 million bread, the line will be lesser. I remember Bajpayee ji used to talk in very symbolic language. ये हीरो होंडा का दाम 35,000 रुपया क्यों है ब्लैक का ये क्यों चलना चाहिए अब ही सेड वन थिंग वी रियलाइज ही इज वांटिंग अस टू पुश रिफॉर्म इन द ऑटोमोबाइल सेक्टर एंड विद इन कपल ऑफ इयर्स यू सॉ यू वॉक इन टू ऑटोमोबाइल सेंटर एंड टेक योर व्हीकल और ए मोटरसाइकिल और ए कार आफ्टर सम टाइम आई रिमेंबर व्हेन आई बिकेम एन एमपी फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम आई कैन गिव 100 फोन्स The first year, 2000, was a big load. Then we started pushing reform in the telecom sector. And today no one asked me. And I had to tell my PA in Patna, jo mange usko de do. At times it is also there. As I see it, if I can say so in Hindi, Jyotsna, with your kind permission, is mulk mein roti ko baantne ki siyasat bahut hui hai. Roti ki sankhya kaise badhe, ye siyasat bahut kam hui hai. And the Narendra Modi government is designed to increase the number of bread to ensure equity. That is the fundamental premise which you need to understand. For this to happen, you need to have good policy initiative. You need to have a firm political leadership. You have to have honesty. You have to have commitment. And above all, fundamental principles of good governance. These are very important. And I can tell you, all of you know the world and the worldly ways of India and the world. I can say very proudly, under the government of Narendra Modi today, while the policy paralysis is a thing of the past, the decision making are done in a very fair, reasonable manner. You have seen what happened in the Sanchar Bhavan, which I had to handle as a telecom minister earlier, in the coal and others are well known. This demonetization is in line with the transformative program Shri Narendra Modi as the Prime Minister has initiated. Digital India, Make in India, Skill India, Startup India, Stand Up India, Smart Cities are all designed to make India a knowledge-empowered economy. And this whole demonetization is a long-term initiative to make India a more transparent society. If you ask my view, how should we take it? Do we need to make our armed forces some of the best in the world or not? If we need to make, we need to have bigger revenue to give them the logistics, the equipment, the training. The other thing needed to make India a modern army. Do we need to make India a hub of innovation on research or not? Whenever as an IT minister I go to Bangalore, I see a long group of innovative people working for multinationals. I have no problem there. Don't misunderstand me. But should or should we not encourage them with greater innovation to have good patents in their name so that India becomes a hub of international patents? For that, we need investment. We need to give them more support. All this requires huge financial implications, and the government must have that. How a transformative program becomes a milestone, I would like to give an example. And I've given at some other congregations also. In the Bajpai government, I was a junior minister, coal and mines, then I became law and justice and information broadcasting. There was a meeting on this national highway program. And naysayers are always there, a big meeting. Jameen kahan se aayegi? Itna compensation kahan se aayega? From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, we need to have an highway. From Silchar to Surat, we need to have 4-lane, 6-lane highway. It was a couple of hours meeting. Bajpai ji kept on listening. He was a very powerful speaker outside, but in meetings, he used to speak very less. And all of us were looking towards him. Lastly, he said one sentence, "Karna hai, karo." That's all. About 7 to 8 months ago, I had gone to Kanyakumari in a public function, Jyotsna and Harsh. And where my public function was held, I was told that Kashmir to Kanyakumari 4-6-lane highway terminates there. I asked my secretary how much time I have to go to the airport. They said, "You have 1 hour spare." In my lifetime, I may not get the chance to drive all the way from Kashmir to Kanyakumari. But let me drive for 30, 40 minutes to have a feel. If you have a commitment, if you have a determination, if you have the honesty to implement, India can change and we can change. That's how we look at things. Let me briefly give you the digital profile of India, because all of you are important people. Therefore, this is important for you to know. And I have been an activist of my student life. Sudhir Babu is sitting here. He knows me for a long time. So does Harsh. I became an activist in the JP movement long years, working with Arun Jaitley in the Vidyarthi Parishad, in the party's youth wing. I have seen India grow. I have been in charge of 7-8 states of India on behalf of my party, in parliament, governance experience. But the sheer tectonic change I am experiencing in India as the IT minister of India is mind-boggling. And I can tell you, ladies and gentlemen, India is at the cusp of a big change. With one caveat, we are not acknowledging it. And today, I will give you a very brief substance of what I am experiencing for you to understand and applaud them. In a population of 1.25 billion plus, India is home to 1.04 billion mobile phones. Out of that, 35 crores are smartphones. In the 2 years, 3-4 months of Narendra Modi government, we have added mobile phones in India equal to the population of France and Italy. We are home to 108 billion Aadhaar card, a verifiable digital identity duly backed by law. We are 50 crore internet, landline and wireless. And the biggest startup movement picking up in the world, that is India. How technology helps? Let me give you one instance. Jandhan account, you must have heard along. We have 25 crore Jandhan accounts. We link Jandhan with Aadhaar and the mobile. The jam trinity you must have heard about. We started sending all the government subsidy, ration, kerosene in some states, your gas subsidy. Ladies and gentlemen, we have saved 40,000 crores, which was pilfered by middlemen or non-existent people. That is what technology is about. Recently, we heard from Maharashtra. Many of you may be knowing, tribal students are given government scholarship in the hostel, funded by the government, all fee, teachers, etc., hostel fee. All were sought to be brought on Aadhaar. The number of students went down by 40%. The first counting was done, the second counting was done, the third counting was done. And then they said, ki, sir, ab yahi hai, baki log sirf kagaj padte. The same was teacher, 20% down. Digital governance is good governance. Digital governance is transparent governance. Digital governance is honest governance. That's what we are saying. Let me give you 3-4 instances as to how India is changing. The Prime Minister Narendra Modi was speaking to Indians in London in the Wembley Stadium. He took the name of one Imran Khan and said, Imran Khan of Alwar are changing India. I was also watching him as to what my leader says. I told the CMD of BSNL, I was then telecom minister, the Alwar manager of BSNL must reach him tomorrow, give him a bouquet on my behalf, and make him talk to me in the morning tomorrow. At 9 o'clock in the morning, the phone came. He said, the manager is waiting with a bouquet on your behalf. Then Imran Khan came in line, and I will recount in Hindi how the talk went off. Humne kaha, janab, PM sahab ne aapka kal London mein naam liya, aapko malum hai. कहा जी सर मैं तो सो गया था लेकिन पड़ोसियों ने कहा उठो पीएम तुम्हारा नाम ले रहे हैं हमने कहा क्या करते हैं आप कहे सर मैं अलवर संस्कृत विद्यालय में गणित का शिक्षक हूँ दिस व्हाट ही सेड हमने कहा और क्या करते हैं आप कहा सर मैं ऐप्स बनाता हूँ कहा किसके लिए कहा बच्चों के लिए फिजिक्स केमिस्ट्री मैथमेटिक्स कैलकुलस एडवांस मैथमेटिक्स एलिमेंट्री मैथमेटिक्स कहा कितने बच्चे यूज़ करते हैं कहा 30 लाख बच्चे यूज़ करते हैं हमने कहा आईटी कहीं से पढ़ा है कहा नहीं सर मैं तो सिर्फ बीए और बीएड हूँ लेकिन मेरे भाई साहब कुछ आईटी की किताबें छोड़ गए थे उससे पढ़ के मैं ऐप बनाना सीख गया यू अंडरस्टैंड द पोटेंशियल ऑफ चेंज दे आर unleashing in India. The second potential of Hrithik, I awarded him. He's a 17-year boy. His father runs a souvenir shop in Orchha near Jhansi. Orchha is home to a lot of old forts and is a prized tourist destination for European, particularly Spanish. Now, Spanish don't speak English, and his father was speaking broken English. He realized the problem, went on Google, took a crash course of Spanish in 1 month, and started speaking Spanish. And the tourist learned that there is a little boy who talks in Spanish. Let's go to that shop, and the business boomed. There is a startup in Delhi, Digital Desh, which goes to nook and corner of the country in a car and records the changing life of India through their smartphone and mobile phone. It is phenomenal, ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you, and makes me very confident that India is at the cusp of a big change. Let me tell you the case of Bajanti Devi of Bodh Gaya in Bihar, running common service centers. Very poor, extremely deprived, also tortured inside the family. Someone she took a fancy for the mouse in training course. And we have got 2 lakh plus common service centers all over the country where they make Aadhaar, they make digital transaction, at times insurance, banking. I also got them linked with Baba Ramdev's Patanjali. They are distributing that. We got them a link with Uber to recruit drivers digitally from the hills of India and the plains of India. It is a big movement. I call them the digital force on the ground. Now that lady, the way she is giving service, it's truly amazing. The Ratna Devi of Alwar, she is training only Banjara ladies, making them digitally literate. All of them today are going to train 1 crore citizens of India and 20 lakh shopkeepers in the mode of digital payment. And we have got a proper portal. It started only 4 days ago. Till day before yesterday, it was 5 lakh. Yesterday, it rose to 7 lakh, and my APS just told me the number. We have 10 lakh citizens registered, 9.5 lakh trained, shopkeepers trained 31,000, district cover 476, blocks cover 1,441. The same people on the ground, how fast they are going. And what we are giving them? Rupees 10 per training, rupees 100 per training camp, and rupees 200 per shopkeepers. And another mode of digital payment which we are pushing in a very big way is Aadhaar-based payment. About 30 crore Indians do not have mobile, but they have access. In a family, there may be one mobile. All of you may be keeping 2 mobiles. But how they should have the benefit, and that we are encouraging Aadhaar-based payment, where I'm going to work with Finance Ministry and the overall supervision of Arun Jaitley ji. And it's very simple. I want to show it today. This is the biometrics. This is the smartphone. You just push it here, and what he will do, the shopkeeper is asked 200 to be paid. Yes, he will say pay 200. He will say give your Aadhaar number. Aadhaar number is there. You have to press just your fingerprint here, and the payment is done. The bank account has to be Aadhaar linked bank account. And about 40 crore bank accounts today are Aadhaar linked. We are going to increase it further. Therefore, Indians' passion for technology is phenomenal. And yesterday evening I got a report that my common service centers have already undertaken 2 lakh transactions through this system, leading to about almost 500 crores all over the country. And how I reward them? Recently, we have a trade fair in the Pragati Maidan, where the theme was Digital India. And I asked my staff, meri photo choti lagaoge, वैजंती देवी रीति की फोटो बड़ी बड़ी लगाओगे. लेट कंट्री सी हाउ इंडिया इज चेंजिंग एंड दे एब्सोल्युटली फ्लोर्ड. हमने कहा नहीं, यू आर द हीरोज. टुडे इन फिक्की, हर्ष ज्योत्सना जी, आई विल रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू बिकम ए पार्ट ऑफ दिस प्रोसेस इन ट्रेनिंग, इन टेलिंग द शॉपकीपर्स दैट बिकम डिजिटल. GST is coming, I'm sure Arun Jaitley must have talked about it in a big way. But it is important that GST is going to be technology enabled. Therefore, this digital payment is going to become the ancillary and the companion of GST in a big way, I would like to highlight. One particular number I would like to share. We have 6.3 crore enterprise in India. 2.24 crore do not have an office or address. Only 85 lakh have any form of tax registration. Only 11 lakh pay the mandatory provident fund. And only 18,000 companies have a paid up capital of more than 10 crores. Many of the 6.3 crore firms would now move into formal economy. Now you should understand, I remember when I used to practice and when this tax at source started, the lawyers used to get irritated. Ye kya hai bhai? Fees mili nahi, tax kat gaya. But they started enjoying it. At least now I am safe. Digital payment, I have always said, and yesterday the Prime Minister said a very extraordinary, extraordinary observation in our MPs meeting. Two things which need to be clarified here. If any enterprise or a shopkeeper comes on digital payment mode, for small shopkeepers, middle shopkeepers, no opening shall be done about transaction before 8th of November. Okay? This clarity needs to be restated. It has come in the news also today. And the second is, in terms of labor employment, if a concern by digital payment, the number of employees rises or something like that, no inquiry should be made pre-8th of November in case of a small shopkeepers or other concerns. So that past is past. What is important is it to bring into digital mode in a bigger way. But understand one thing, as the PM rightly said. If your transaction is digital, your consumer base is known. And if your consumer base is known, the lending banks would have enough material available about your commercial viability to expedite the loan system. The money comes in the system, becomes available for banks to invest, maybe consider lowering rates if RBI agrees, which it must in the future, I suppose. And as our Honorable Finance Minister has indicated, the tax rate may come down. The whole economy will become on a different highway altogether, designed to make India an honest, more in terms of delivery, faster and greater accountability. And let me tell you, once this process starts, attendant consequences of reform will start as a part of the process. People ask me now, the Law Minister of India talking to you, what will happen to this, what will happen to that. Once the India turns digital, the way we are pushing e-courts in the country is all going very fine. We are going to speed it up. Before I conclude, Harsh is very keen, I should also speak a word about the Law Minister of India. I will come to law, but one thing about electronic, because Jyotsna ji rightly pointed out how India is changing, I will very briefly give you a few instances. I just talked about mobile phones. Then I asked my officers, isme Hindustan mein banta kitna hai? Kaha sir, ek factory hai. Unhone kaha, ye nahi chalega. We have to make India a hub of electronic manufacturing. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm very happy to tell you, in the last 1 year, 6 months, India has got 40 new mobile manufacturing units in India, including some of the best in the world who have come. And yesterday, the Cellular Association told me that 30 ancillary factories of battery chargers have also come. About 50,000 direct employment, and 1.5 to 1.75 lakh indirect employment. And 11 have come only in Noida and Greater Noida. When I was minister, about 11,000 crore of investment has come in electronic manufacturing. Now it has crossed 1,26,000 crores. You all know we have got a system of giving modified incentives, which is going to continue, and we are going to... And our theme is very clear. Come, make in India for India and also export outside. And we are very keenly focusing and encouraging them to make India's neighborhood, the ASEAN countries, the Gulf countries, as a big hub of their business proposition based from manufacturing in India. But yes, I am very firm on one thing also. When a particular company was keen to make India a hub of their second-hand operations, we were firm to tell them, sorry, India is not the place for second-hand. Make first-hand. India is too big a market. And people are coming here. Well, ladies and gentlemen, there is a philosophy behind it. Digital India. And what is the philosophy? We miss the Industrial Revolution. We miss the entrepreneurial revolution of the 60s, 70s, 80s and 90s. We don't want to miss the digital revolution. We want to become the leaders in that. And Digital India is a program designed for that. Now, very briefly about the Law Ministry, let me tell you, our commitment to the independence of judiciary is total. And I don't say so for the saying of it. This government is led by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Arun Jaitley, Sushma Swaraj, Venkaiah Naidu, Rajnath Singh, Ravi Shankar Prasad, some 4 or 5 years senior, some 4 or 5 years junior. All of them were activists in the JP movement, have fought against the emergency, suffered for 3 freedoms. Individual freedom, media freedom, and independence of judiciary. Therefore, we have fought for the independence of judiciary. This fact should be known. But what I said on the 26th of November, while addressing the Constitution Day organized by the Supreme Court in a lecture by Justice Venkat Chalaiya, I would like to say it again. Because Harsh wants me to speak. Therefore, Harsh, for your sake, I'm speaking. And what is that? India is today 70 years as an independent country. And certain fundamental issues are well established. And what is that? India will be governed by the popular mandate of the people of India, by their vote, in a free and fair election. After the disastrous experience of Indira Gandhi in the 70s, no leader will dare to impose emergency in India. And there shall be no military coup in India. People will vote, change the leader in a center or a state, a party in the center of the state. Number two, certain fundamental freedoms are now recognized. Freedom of speech, freedom of association, freedom of movement, freedom of media. These are well-recognized freedoms which cannot be curbed except to the strict standards permitted under the Constitution itself. Number three, judiciary is independent. We respect that and we should continue to respect that. An Indian judiciary exercising the power of judicial review can set aside any order passed by any government, can quash any law passed by any parliament or Vidhan Sabha if found to be lacking in constitutional compliances. Court can also give directions if there is a failure to undertake any obligation. But there is also a fourth principle, fundamental, quite established by the Constitution of India and by the framers of our Constitution. And what is that? Governance must be left to those elected to govern by the people of India. Legislation must be left to those elected to legislate by the people of India. And policy making must be left to those elected to frame policy by the people of India. If these fundamental principles are recognized, and that is what the Constitution is about, then India's strength as the biggest democracy of the world is going to acquire greater momentum, greater constitutional sanctity, and greater constitutional depth. And that's what I strongly believe. But yes, having said that, I must remind that justice delivery is integral to good governance. And therefore, we are increasing our whole approach to make India a good hub of national arbitration, international arbitration. We have already appointed 126 High Court judges, the highest ever since 1990 till now. The highest was 121 in 2013. Average judges appointed are only 90. We have appointed about 4 Supreme Court judges. We have appointed about 30 or transferred High Court judges, Chief Justices. And we have also confirmed about 124 additional judges. Yes, I must remind, we came with the National Judicial Commission Act, with the Supreme Court quashed it. But regardless of that, we have obeyed the judgment. And the same judgment the Supreme Court has said, collegium system needs to be improved. They asked the government to reframe the memorandum of procedure. We have given up the view pending with the Supreme Court's view since August 3rd, 2016. This is how it stands. But let me assure you people from the FICCI that our commitment to a free judiciary is complete and total. All the help needed to strengthen the architecture of judiciary will be given. And just to give one instance, nearly 5,000 crores have been spent since the days of Narasimha Rao in reinforcing the judicial architecture of India. More judges, more court halls, more residences. Out of that 5,000 crores, 2,000 crore has been spent in the 2 year, 3 months of Narendra Modi government. And we shall continue to help that. Ladies and gentlemen, it was wonderful talking to you. But let me conclude with a great sense of hope. India is at the cusp of big change. I have not the slightest doubt that very soon India will come in the comity of nations of the world. It has already come, where India will be treated with greater respect for good economy, for good investment, for good growth. I'm sure in that larger goal, FICCI always will continue to participate as it has done. Nice talking to you. Thank you. Namaskar. Jai Hind.
Thank you very much, Honorable Minister. That was very inspiring. We've got about 10 minutes of question answers. And yes, we'll pass the mic around. But may I begin by asking him a question, sir?
Yes, maybe. Yes,
I'm going to ask you for both your avatars, your avatar as information technology and as law minister. For information technology, I would like you to answer me this question, sir, that within this existing framework that we have, the infrastructure, what are the key challenges that you are facing in the implementation of this remonetization? And we've also seen some interesting exchange of views on the issues of judges' appointments. What should we expect going forward on the appointment of judges? So after you've answered that, I'm going to open it up to the House.
I think she has asked both the loaded question. Therefore, there is no need for any further question. But anyway, very quickly. The first and foremost is the mindset. And I'm sure Arunji must have explained. It is not a cashless, it is a less cash. Those who have bona fide cash, why not? Those who have a legitimate explained, why not? So that is one thing. That is, one is the psychological issue, which we need to talk over, where I need the cooperation of all of you. My take, Jyotsna, on technology for Indians is this. Indians first observe technology. Then they adopt it. Then they start enjoying it. And then they become empowered in the process. And on the second day, when I saw from the window of my Shastri Bhavan, a pakoda wala has put up, yahan Paytm accept hota hai. He realized that if he wants his pakoda to be sold, he has to go on technology. That is India. So that is what we have to do. But yes, I am very happy. I wanted to tell you that this year our IT companies have done extraordinary. Almost 8 lakh crores of India's IT products have been exported. They are present in about 80 countries of 200 cities of 80 countries. We're very proud of them, and I'm sure new innovation will come about. Regarding the judges part, our role is very clear. Jo naam High Court se aayenge, wahi to hum karenge. Jo naam Supreme Court se aayenge, wahi to hum karenge. Ab Supreme Court mein 7 vacancy hai. Abhi tak naam nahi aaye. Naam aayenge, hum process karenge. Ab High Court mein 430 vacancy hai. And out of those 430 vacancies, we haven't received name for about 280 from the High Courts. It will come, we will expedite. But what is important is, if there is a judicial view of Constitution Bench to strengthen the collegium system more transparent, more fair, more objective, I think the government of India is keen to work with the Supreme Court to do that.
Thank you. Mr. Jalan.
Ab Sudhir Babu bhi puchenge sawal.
शंकर जी जोसना जी ने आपको दोनों अवतार में पूछा. आई विल आस्क यू क्वेश्चन टू इन वन. यू हैव डन ट्रिमेंडस वर्क ऑन आईटी रिवोल्यूशन.
थैंक यू सर.
हाउ डू यू डू दैट इन द जुडिशियरी सो दैट द प्रोसेस कुड बी एक्सपेडाइटेड.
अब देखिए, इसमें हमारे मीडिया के दोस्त अगर बदमाशी नहीं करेंगे तो मैं एक बात कहना चाहता हूं. आईटी में रविशंकर प्रसाद मोदी जी से निर्देश लेते हैं और फैसला करते हैं और काम करते हैं. जुडिशरी में हमको जुडिशरी के साथ काम करना पड़ता है, उनका सम्मान करते हुए. आई हैव टू वर्क इन कोऑपरेशन विद द जुडिशरी अंडर देयर गाइडेंस एंड वी वर्क वेरी वेल. बट एट टाइम सिचुएशन बिकम स्लो, वी हैव टू वर्क टुगेदर. बट आई कैन टेल यू जुडिशरी इज इक्वली कीन टू इंश्योर ट्रांसपेरेंसी, फास्टर डिलीवरी. As I told about arbitration, I talked about mediation. Sometime you will call me to talk more as a law minister, I will surely call. But what is important is, for instance, let me tell you, 5,000 posts of subordinate judiciary is vacant. District courts all over the country. In that I have no role, nor the state government has a role. Only the high courts, or at their instance, the Public Service Commission. So those are areas of challenge. We are working together, surely we will work. जिसको ये आइडेंटिफाई करेंगे उसे मैं उत्तर दूंगा. हाँ, आप आइडेंटिफाई करिए.
या यस प्लीज
काइंडली इंट्रोड्यूस योरसेल्फ.
प्लीज इंट्रोड्यूस योरसेल्फ.
आई एम एनजी खैतान. आप हमारे ब्रिक कॉन्फ्रेंस को लास्ट टाइम इनॉग्रेट किए थे. कल हमारी इंडियन काउंसिल ऑफ आर्बिट्रेशन की AGM भी थी और सेमिनार भी थी. इस साल हमने प्राइम मिनिस्टर का की वक्तव्यता लेते हुए कि वी मस्ट मेक इंडिया एज एन इंटरनेशनल आर्बिट्रेशन, हमने 3 इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंस यहाँ पर करी एंड हमारे 40 इंटरनेशनल लॉयर्स इंडिया में आए. 40 इंटरनेशनल लॉयर्स फ्रॉम ऑल पार्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. कल हमारी AGM में एक इशू उठी कि हम लोग क्यों बाहर नहीं जाते हैं. तो हमको रिक्वेस्ट किया गया कि मैं आपको एज ए लॉ मिनिस्टर रिक्वेस्ट करूँ टू टेक अ डेलीगेशन इन फ्यू कंट्रीज विथ मी सो दैट वी कैन प्रोपोगेट इंडिया एज एन हब ऑफ इंटरनेशनल आर्बिट्रेशन. और जितने भी लॉयर्स को हमने भारतवर्ष में बुलाए, अबाउट from 14 countries they came, they said that your law of arbitration is very robust. Thank you.
I have already set up a committee, I'll disclose it very shortly, of very eminent judges of India to give suggestions to make India more a bigger hub. What is to be done? Instead of going to foreign country, it is important to set India first, all right. Then I'll go abroad with you. But what is important is that I would like to flag here, and I told you also in your conference, if a new kind of imperialism is emerging in arbitration, it is not acceptable to me as the law minister of India. India has got some of the finest lawyers and finest judges. But why is it that only Queen's Counsel barristers are hopping from one arbitration to another and giving heavy punitive awards? And this is not fair. South Africa, many African countries are deeply agitated. We need to find a proper resolution to that. And I am too Indian to acknowledge that only Queen's Counsel barristers are the best arbitrators of the world. Sorry, that is not acceptable.
Yes, a mic there, please. Please Please introduce yourself to the minister.
Sir, first of all, heartiest compliments. It was a very inspiring address.
Thank you.
I am Mukesh Patel, National Executive Committee member, former president of the Gujarat Chamber of Commerce and Industry. And this question comes to you, sir, because I am myself an advocate. The Prime Minister had shared this dream of his that, you know, on the legal arena, there are so many laws which are there in our country now, which are more or less obsolete or with obsolete provisions. You know, they have come to us as a part of a British heritage. And we really need to, because I think a lot of complications arise because we are still, you know, taking up cases in courts of law for such puny limits or such frivolous provisions, which only if the laws were amended or scrapped, I think we could have had a much faster and efficient system.
I get your point. We have already scrapped 1,500 laws after we came to power. And the major, and many of them were of Sudhir Babu's state, Bengal. There was a Sarai Act. In the British time, in 18th century, when you used to visit, you have to pay a Sarai tax. All these were there. But yes, my point is well taken. We are re-examining the whole issue. This whole Benami Act, we changed that or not? You have seen that. No regulation framed since 1988. So that we are doing. And it is an ongoing process. And many old laws of the states are there. We have also recommended to the state government to take in a proactive measure.
So just one, I'll take that question first and then come back to you. Please give a mic there. And then
so many ladies are there. Should I presume no lady is going to ask a question when Jyotsna ji is anchoring
any,
it?
Will, Naina?
Anyway, go ahead. The lighter wind.
No, we'll get Naina to ask you a question.
Sir, myself is Jatin Trivedi. I'm a chairman legal committee, subcommittee legal at Gujarat State, and practicing in intellectual property field. Sir, as you rightly said about the patent in the case of the Bangalore incident which you referred, as a practitioner, what probably I see, I would like to have your views on the same, and if the system, what we have it at the government, if that can be helpful to the practitioners to help the industry for protecting their intellectual property. Sir, what the challenge which we face is that the awareness of the intellectual property, with all due respect to the judicial officer sitting at the higher level, that is one. And second is that can we have a system where at least not an intellectual property court separately sitting, but at least a dedicated judge within the system, within the all the appointed judges. So I'm not talking about that having a separate setup for the intellectual property, which is part of the judiciary in the international world. But in India, probably we can have a dedicated judge who can deal with the intellectual property, sir.
Your point is well taken. There is a greater awareness among the judiciary about patent laws, its implications, the best practices of the world. But remember, judiciary is judiciary. And it is also the job of the lawyer to educate the judge well. Okay? That is also the job of the lawyer. Therefore, both has to go about. If certain institutional changes are needed, if you give some suggestions, you are most welcome.
Naina, are you going to ask a question? A mic. Okay.
Always so energizing to hear you and all that you are doing in two critical areas, specifically the area of the internet and our courts. On the internet, and my question to you is really as a recent visitor to China, where I was very struck that over 50% of the population are very much on the internet all the time. And the quality of internet there versus here, where I know you are working to close this gap. How soon do you envisage that we could be at the same sort of levels that China has in terms of internet efficiency? And I was in conversation, in fact, say, with the Uber CEO, and he also has had to develop many ways to ensure that the internet doesn't drop through the technology offering that they have, loops through SMS, etc., which clearly tells me we have a ways to go in terms of the quality of internet and the coverage. So how soon do you envisage, given all that you are doing, that we can close this gap?
I can only draw upon my past experience as a telecom minister of India. Okay. we are doing a big program of optical fiber network, connecting 250 lakh gram panchayats of India by optical fiber. And the speed with which you work is, earlier it was known as NOFAN. In the Manmohan Singh's government, in 3 years, 358 kilometers of optical fiber was laid. In the Narendra Modi's government of 2 years, 3 months, 1,42,000 kilometers of optical fiber has been laid. That is the speed we work with. I think by next year, March, we will complete 1 lakh gram panchayat. And by that, it is 2018 middle, it will be complete. Many of them are functioning well. We are very soon coming with a digital village concept, which we are working on. We'll disclose that at an appropriate time, but very shortly. Lot of alternative technology is also coming. These common service centers have been given the right to pick up villages, and through this new system of microwave and others, start giving digital services. Let me tell you, Nana, thanks for the kind words. India is going to be home to $1 trillion business opportunity in the coming 5 years. From technology, to internet, to electronic manufacturing, to e-commerce rising. Therefore, technology is going to become a big success financially, commercially. And sure, the telecom operators have to work very fast. There is one problem which they suffer, which I need to tell here. While they need to further reinforce their architecture, this uncalled for campaign against radiation, it also takes us no far. Okay. Mm-hmm. Cancer ho jayega, goraiya mar jayegi. These kind, we have examined it medically from the WHO to others. And since you talked of China, is radiation an issue in China? Is it an issue in Europe? Is it an issue in New York? Whenever I go to New York, I always look for the towers. They keep on either hiding it or on the top of the buildings. Why this sustained campaign by certain interested persons in India only? Because we are becoming a big power. I think these are also issues where I would like FICCI to work together. But your point is well taken. And I'm sure your message is to us in the government, and your message is also to the telecom operators to improve their network.
So just two more questions, one here and then one behind. Please be brief.
Sir, I'm R.S. Joshi from Guwahati, Assam. Sir, in our part of this northeast part of country, you'll be surprised to know this very basics of digitization and so many benefits of Aadhaar card. Aadhaar cards are yet to be issued in the state of Assam. Our boys and girls have been instrumental in changing the perception about Northeast. You find them working very well in Wipro, TCS, and all the IT companies. We would not like to miss the bus of digitization. What's your government's plan to address this very, very core issue of Northeast?
You know, Aadhaar was kept out of Assam and probably Meghalaya because of infiltration problem. You know it very well. But we'll have to address it. Therefore, National Population Register is working well. But your point is well taken. But don't forget, I visit Northeast quite frequently. And I know in the software technology park, in the call center program, we had got it for the Northeast. It's picking up very well. I appreciate the IT savviness of Northeastern people. But National Population Register is going to replace very soon about the Aadhaar needs.
The last question.
Yes.
Sir, so far as the legal system is concerned, there is no issue with the laws, but there is an issue with the system, implementation. A suit goes on and on and on. So there must be some mechanism should be devised so that early judgments can be given, one. And secondly, so far as finance suits or recovery suits are concerned, it takes long years and years. So I suggest that there should be a tribunal. And what happens, a judiciary does not understand the accounts. So there must be a tribunal. There must be a tribunal to settle that, those accounts, those issues.
Jyotsna and Harsh, I suppose you'll have to fix an extra hour with me on legal issues only. Okay. Therefore, in future programs, I will come more as a law minister of India than IT minister of India. You see, there are two ways of looking at it. One, we have changed the system. Summons, delivery, framing of issues. Court commissioners can go to record the evidence. All these things have been done. The court have to become more proactive. But also the clients will have to become more proactive, and their lawyers too. It has to be a collective issue. And I don't agree that judges don't know accounts. They understand so many tax laws after Supreme Court, High Court judges give or not. But what is important is tribunal part, they will be doing the same thing well, is too tall a claim. I think for civil suit, system should go on. But yes, mediation and arbitration come about in a big way. And as the Law Minister of India, we are encouraging mediation and arbitration for settling of old money dues. If you have any concrete suggestion to give, kindly give. But Sudhir Babu, there is a famous story of lawyers from Calcutta. I hope it is not in lighter vein. Media, I hope you understand that. I make some fun with my old friends. And they said ki there was a grandson who began law practice. And he told his grandfather, he was a lawyer and father was a lawyer. Kaki, grandpa, you'll be happy to know that 40 years old suit today I have compromised. He said, you will never succeed as a lawyer. That was the gift given to me by my father when I started practicing. Okay, so I hope that Calcutta tendency all need to be get curbed.
But this thank is you, thank you very much, sir. Fabulous, absolutely fabulous. Sir, we've just...